Well, I was just wondering, since Pat owned that, I was just wondering if he, you know, put buildings up.
I have heard he's gonna put something up, but I don't know. Like I said, haven't talked to Pat at all. He just got.
I mean, you know, they're just sitting there empty right now, and they could be too.
Yeah, I hope so. I really hope so. I really do.
Yeah.
Louise tried to get people to come to town, and he tried to dress me tonight to come in, and they went to Lakin instead. But no, we're always trying, and always welcoming, I mean, you know.
It's difficult, Woody. It's difficult to get anybody to come anywhere. I mean, I'm on the Economic Development Committee in Lakin. It's difficult for us, but it's a lot easier for us than it is for Sparland, because we have something to offer.
Right.
Sparland doesn't have a lot to offer, and that's what we're faced with. It's not that, I mean, we encourage everybody. They're all welcome. We don't discourage them.
But if we had the buildings, you know.
Well, who's gonna build the buildings? City kid, the city's in no position to do it. We have trouble paying our bills.
We even contacted one of the TIF people, and to even get a TIF program set up costs you $30,000. And we didn't have the $30,000. I mean, you could've made money in the long run, but we didn't have the money to, you know, and they're only going by one section. We'd probably have to set it up for four sections, so it's gonna cost it a small fortune just to set it up, you know, but you can make a lot of money through the TIF, but you gotta have money to make money.
TIF has been very instrumental.
That's the old saying.
TIF has been very instrumental in Lakin.
Yeah.
TIF brought Dollar General, Shell Station, revitalized the downtown, but like Linda says, it costs us $30,000 just to establish it. We don't have that.
We've been working on things like this.
We have looked into a TIF here, though, which is tax increment financing is what that boils down to.
Okay, Sharon, I think we
Oh, that's all right. There is something I'd like to say, and it's not against anyone, but me personally, I truly do not approve of your new trustee because of the fact that he is a renter. He's not a homeowner, and he can leave at any time, and he's making major, major decisions about our village. And I do not understand why this has happened.
It's happened before. Other people that's rented and not homeowners. I don't think that disqualifies them to be on the village board.
Legally, it doesn't. This is just my own personal.
Well, you really have a hard time getting people to serve on the board too.
Wonder why.
There's been many, many years. I think Nancy can attest to that. You have to beg people to come onto the board, you know, to get somebody. And so a young man like him that's willing and able and interested and.
Won't hurt to oppose his brothers too, though.
By law, you can't distinguish between a renter and a homeowner.
No, by law you can't.
Now, that was just her own personal.
That was just my own personal.
That's a moral judgment, and I don't think that we can make that about others.
I have that right.
And I still stand at my original point of, if anybody else lived across the street from them, they'd be against them too.
Is that the main reason you're here, is because of Fluffers? It's not
main
for
reason of the city?
Yeah, for the
no,
village.
Ma'am. No. It's because, and in fact, if you want to call Jeff Holacker, I'm in the process of buying that house. We're waiting for an appraiser to come out and appraise the house.
Hope it don't flood.
Which Mike directed that. He made his unofficial visit to my house to tell me to deal with Fluffers because it wasn't going anywhere.
Well, it's not. It's not, sir.
You know, what happened to the live entertainment license that is in the ordinance that Charlie had to get when he was there?
You'll have to ask these other people here. I've tried to get ordinance.
No, it's already in the ordinance.
It's on hold.
It's already in the ordinance. And if we go back and we want to find things that were mishandled by mayors, I believe the mayor before had something in writing, but it was never passed in an ordinance to where this, somewhere back here behind this house, was going to be a park. Well, if that would have been a park, that would have eliminated
You're
the
right.
strip club from opening up.
You're right.
1983, that was under Philip Murphy's.
Cows had wings that could fly.
We're not talking about cows,
I looked it up, and that's, you know, it's all under the you know, that stuff's all under the bridge. We looked it up, we established a park, no other ones can come into town. We got that taken care of, so.
And he's not, the guy that's over there, the main bulldog behind that whole thing is the guy that owns Club Cabaret. If you Google this club, the owner of Club Cabaret is what comes up, talking about it. And talking about him and the guy that's running the place, how they're buddies, and he's gonna really put Sparlin on the map.
Already done it.
Boy, is it.
Okay, Charlie?
Yes, I had an issue here a while back when I was discussing this water bill situation that I didn't understand all of what you said on it, all. And then when Mike brought up to try to make a motion to let the public have a little input on this stuff here, and it was shot down tremendously, I'm thinking, now what's the matter here? Don't these people want to hear our opinion on what's going on here? He gave us a chance to talk, and the board shot him down completely like that. We couldn't even ask a question. You couldn't, what, you don't want to hear the public's opinion on what's going on here? Then the other issue, well, the other thing I want to say while I got the time here, I want to thank the people, Charlie Kerr, Wayne, Mike, Sean, the ones that helped clean out that creek in front of our house there and keep that water running fine. We finally got some help in there, clean that creek out, and I want to give them people there a lot of credit for being down there. I was down there as much as I could, clean that creek out and out of where the water flows.
I give them credit too.
They did, them people did real well on that.
I know they did.
Yeah.
I know they did, and we give them credit.
Yeah.
I haven't seen all of them, but I've seen Charlie and talked to him, but I haven't seen him.
We've been down.
I don't know who all worked there, but I know Wayne did.
Yeah, but yeah, that issue with the water thing, when he gave us to ask for a chance, everybody just bowed their heads like that, and I thought, what the hell?
Do you understand what we were talking about? Did I explain it to where you understood it?
Or? No, it didn't. That's why I bitched it out, because I didn't understand it and didn't give my voice and ask any questions.
The $140 surcharge, is that what you're talking about?
Yeah, the surcharge. Now, what do you mean by if you owe...
Explain a surcharge, Betsy.
If you owe the residents that much money, you're talking about from the past, what we paid in? Okay, go ahead, Betsy.
Okay, that's what you're talking about.
Okay.
The ordinance that was passed back in October, I believe.
Passed illegally back then.
Right. It wasn't valid because of the proxy voting.
Right.
But the money, I mean, that was unbeknownst, and so the money was collected, put on the water bill, and everyone paid their water bill.
Yeah.
So there's been an overpayment.
Yeah.
So in order to correct that, the $140 surcharge is equal to the amount of what the overpayment was. But then you get a credit right back for the $140.
We now get a credit back for the $140 where we don't have to pay our water bill until the $140 is paid back to us.
No. No, it's a wash.
It's a wash.
Mm-hmm.
That's what
it's a wash. It's the there's a $140 surcharge that will show on your bill.
Okay, I'm lost.
That's like a one-time charge of $140. It's gonna show up on your water bill. But you've already paid $140 from the October. So that's paid that $140 surcharge. So you're paid up. You see what I mean? Does that make more sense?
No, maybe I'm stupid. I don't know.
No, you're not stupid. I'm just not explaining it right,
I guess. It's a wash, like we got washed.
No.
Yeah,
what
we got
it
washed.
What it is, I think, from the way I'm understanding is, technically, everybody was charged $10 extra a month for 14 months,
right.
Which they shouldn't have been. You have two options. Pay all that money back, which is $20,000-some.
$28,000.
Or you have to, basically, to fix the wrong that was done, charge a $140 surcharge instead of the $10 every month for the last 14 months, because technically that wasn't valid. You charge $140 to cover that, basically, and then credit $140 back so that it's even. Yeah. I think is the way that...
That's
And
right.
That's another thing is, other cities do this surcharge. I mean, this is not...
So in other words, we still pay the $45 from now on out, but and that's it, and the 140 that the city owes us is just
gone.
No, well, they get to keep it.
They get to keep it.
But they don't have the money to pay it back anyway.
Yeah. We don't have, and the thing is, here was another option that we didn't go with. We could have had an ordinance tonight to say, okay, we're going to raise your water rates up to $55 a month. That would never go away.
Exactly.
This is a better option than raising it. That 55, you'd be paying it every month from who knows when. So this is the better. Everybody, we can make our water payments. We can fix all these things at the lift station that we have to get fixed. We can pay the water people that come around and put the...
So in other words, all that money that you owe us back, you can put it into something else in the city that... Well, maybe you can help me out down there then with some of that money.
Well, you saw we just had to borrow $100,000 to take care of our water and our sewer plant. Okay, if we'd have had to pay back that $140 to you and every other citizen, it would have cost us $28,000. We would have had to borrow another $28,000 on top of the $100,000. And the only way we could justify that would be by raising the water rate to $55, which we legally can do. We didn't even want to raise it to 45, but to make sure that we keep the system working properly, we had to do it. We don't like to do those things. We pay it also. You have to realize that.
Well, I guess
that.
The problem I had there was that I didn't understand the surcharge and what she was talking about, and then when he asked for the public's opinion to ask the question, straighten it out, we were shot down. That made me mad when they wouldn't let us talk.
Mm-hmm.
Like they're afraid to hear from the public of what's going on around here.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, I'm done.
You done? Bob?
Yeah. I'd like to know, to see in writing, how much it costs to run the water and the sewer. You're saying that I got to pay another $10 a month, and you're going to illegally done it already for $140 for every one of us in here, plus everybody that's not in here. I'd like to see... And what it does cost. We've asked this over and over and over, and we never have seen that. But yet you're borrowing money, and you can't tell me what you got coming in.
It should be on the Treasurer's report that we just had. We just paid bills.
How much it cost to provide the water?
And we have a...
Is that say
what's not on the Treasurer's? Comes out every month is $2,500 for sewer payment,
For sewer payment to who? We don't maintain our own sewer?
We haven't paid for our sewer.
No.
We're still paying for the sewer.
You mean to have it put in?
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
We pay $2,500 a month.
Okay,
for that.
Well, that's what I'm asking you. What is it costing us all together here?
Well, this month.
You want more money, but you can't tell me. You're just going around in circles.
This month is actually one of the cheaper months. It's $3,246.57. And that's cheaper than a lot of times. If we've got a water break, it's up $7,000-$8,000. It changes every month. So no, we can't give you a correct figure because it changes monthly.
Go back several years and average this out and figure out what it's costing you? You're going month by month? That don't sound right to me.
Well, yeah, we could.
You're not going to budget this?
Audit. The audit will do that.
The audit will do it.
We cannot do the audit. We can't give it to them until they get this.
What about last year's audit? What did it come out to?
The what?
The last year's audit.
I'd have to look it up.
I guess you would. But that's what I'd like to know. This has been asked for.
That's the first time I've ever heard you ask for it.
Oh, there's been several people asked for it the last several months. Mm-hmm. And now that's the first time I asked for it, yes. And nobody's ever showed anything on paper to anybody what it's cost to run this town.
Maybe they have asked. I don't know.
Sure they have.
Don't remember.
It should have been in the minutes.
A couple, three people here.
Should have been in the minutes about them asking. So okay. I'm not going to get an answer then.
Well, I'd have to go over here and find it.
Well, that'd be a good idea.
Well, I don't.
What you ought to know, you ought to know you're running this town. How come you don't know?
All the trustees ought to know too, hadn't they?
Yeah, they should. Why don't they?
Well, I don't know.
That's a good answer. I'm done.
I think we could have any other trustee that was ever on in the last 13 years I've been on. They couldn't give you an answer either. Nobody could.
Might be about time to find one.
Well, we'll find it.
Okay, that's good. Next meeting, you're going to have it?
Next meeting, we'll tell you.
Okay, that's what I'd like to see.
I just want to reply to Ralph over there, and you brought up about prior mayors, and this isn't certainly anything, I'm not picking on Linda. I'm dealing with issues that can be corrected now before they get any further out of whack. Your last month, you were another one who sat there, Ralph, when I asked, what are you voting on? Are you not going to tell us? And to which Mayor Madeira says, I don't have to tell you anything. Well, did you not just get served papers by the Attorney General telling you otherwise? And they're entering into a full-blown investigation how you conduct your meetings. So there is a case, and there's a reason why I'm doing this. And when I asked a question at a meeting several months ago, you also sat there and never opened your mouth. And Linda says, you got any questions, submit them through the FOI Act. And now she complains when I do. I'm trying to find out a question. What are you covering up? I found out several things are covering up. I don't care what Roger Wilkinson did, because it's not correctable. It's too far gone. What you're doing today is correctable. What you're doing next month, yeah, I notice you are, and it's appreciated. And one other issue you brought up there is about Mike that attended that meeting, and he talked to Fluffer's attorney. If you were following the law and you had your Ethics Act in line, I'm sure your attorney's going to take care of that, and you had an ethics officer, they could explain this to you. Mike was fully within the confines of the state statute, whereas if somebody in, excuse me, somebody in this room, for example, in a position to give maybe a liquor license or something, I guess that's the biggest thing we have to give in this town is a liquor license. If they accepted a gift, somebody brought them up a case of booze or a stack of ribs to their house, and all of a sudden they got a liquor license, according to the law, they're in violation of it.
Right.
Mike's not done anything wrong.
I just said it looked funny because they were both against it so much till Charlie's the one that said it.
I know, you know, but I agreed. I was against it. I don't like them over there. You know, and I feel bad for Steve and his family. That's terrible. I wouldn't want to live there. I would be a lot madder than Steve is, I'm sure. But the fact is, the reason I agree with them, it's I think the money would be a good thing. That's secondary. It's control. And you asked about who's going to go in there. Well, maybe if you're not comfortable going in there and doing an inspection, if they had a liquor license or some other type of license. I don't know. I bet you Kenny wouldn't be too offended to be showing up in there to go do a building inspection. I mean, I don't think you're looking when the girls are up on stage throwing their G-string across the room for any mention. Maybe it depends when you go. But, you know, I mean, really, you appoint some of your own members, and they do this in other areas. I mean, there is... You don't have to reinvent the machine. There's a method to go in there and deal with it. Right now, you just don't have any control. And all you're left is that a neighbor is like poor Steve over there in the middle of the night and having to wait for a deputy to show up.
That's why we have the two lawyers working on it for control also. Money and control.
Two?
The two lawyers. Our lawyer and their lawyer. Mr. Zaymet.
Okay.
Okay.
Thank you.
You'd asked me if the only reason I was on the board was just because I wanted to get Fluffer shot down. And if that was the case, when Linda stopped at my house the other day and we were talking about snow removal, I actually volunteered to help out with snow removal free of charge. I can't be paid for that because I'm a city official.
That's right.
But obviously, I noticed last year that there was some problems with snow removal, and I volunteered, and she can vouch for that, to help out in the middle of the night, you know, if I got to open. I work 50, 60 hours a week anyways. But I volunteered to sacrifice time with my family and my newborn baby to help get the streets cleaned up because I do care about the town.
That was one of the reasons she came on the board.
A good decision.
Yeah, I said he's a fine young man. People should be happy we have this gentleman here. Kevin Lake, a motion to adjourn the meeting. Motion made by Kenny, second by...